Welcome to H2K Infosys. H2K Infosys is a e-verify business based in Atlanta, Georgia, United States. We provide 100% job-oriented, instructor-led, face-to-face, true live online software training programs. It also includes access to cloud test lab with software tools. We provide live project for you to work on. We also provide assistance with mock interviews, resume preparation and review, and job placement assistance. H2K Infosys is trusted by so many students across the world. H2K Infosys provides world-class services in IT training with real-time project work for corporates and individuals, special IT training for MS students in the United States, software design, development, QA manual and automation, performance testing and maintenance, IT staff augmentation, job placement assistance and tech support.
Okay.
That's right. Yeah.
Yes. Good.
My question is, when it is already calling the super class, the vehicle class constructor, why are we instantiating the vehicle? Why are we passing the car variable to?
We are not passing a car variable. Where are we passing the car variable?
Sorry, the creating car.
I'm just creating multiple objects for your understanding.
Okay.
Vehicle, we can assign it to a vehicle. Car, we can assign it to a car. No confusion about it. Right?
Okay. Thank you.
But the bottom line is, we can assign a subclass object to a superclass reference. Right? So, what will be my output when I run this? In all the three times, the method in the car class, the vehicle class gets called, right? So what happens when I overwrite this method in my car class? See, what am I doing? I'm creating the exact same method in my car class. Means the return type is same, the name is same, and the argument list is same, right? So what happens when I run this class? What will be my output and why?
The first case, it will call the from main program.
Vehicle class. Okay.
Yes. Then second case, it will call from sub.
Call from car
sub,
class.
Car class. Then third case is also car class.
Yes. Folks, this is an instance method. So whenever we overwrite the method in the subclass, we try to change the behavior in the subclass method takes precedence. So this is what is called as overriding. Okay? When you run it, what happens? The subclass method is getting called.
Neha, I have one question. I see that you added the v dot move for all three objects. Is it?
Yes. That is what I'm I think I copy pasted and I didn't change. That's what I was wondering, why the output is all vehicle class. I'm just going to change it. And thank you so much. Because of the copy paste. Okay. So in these two cases, it is calling the method in the car class. Right?
Okay.
So what is overriding? When we have overriding comes into picture only in the case of inheritance, when we have a superclass and a subclass. When we have a method that is defined in the superclass and we want to change the behavior in the subclass, that is what we call it as overriding. In the overriding, the return type of the method, the name of the method, and the argument list should be same. You see, the return type, the name, and the argument list is same as that of the superclass. And during overriding, we cannot reduce the access of the method. For example, in my superclass, if it is public, I can change it, but I cannot restrict it. I cannot make it as protected. But if it is protected in the superclass, I can make it as public here. How the restriction goes, private is more restricted, and then default, and then protected, and then public, right? If it is public over here in the superclass, in the subclass, I have to make the method as public. But if it is protected here, in the subclass, I can make it as protected or I can make it as public. And a method can throw exceptions, which we discuss more when we talk about exception handling. But for now, you can just understand that a method throws exceptions. For example, here, you know, I don't say any exception. For instance, here in the vehicle class, if I say, an exception, it is going to give us error, saying it cannot throw your exception. So if we are throwing an exception here in the superclass, we can throw the same exception or any of its subclasses. In the subclass, we cannot throw newer exceptions than that of the superclass. For example, if superclass is throwing exception 1, 2, 3, in the subclass, we can throw 1 or 2 or 3. I mean, any of the combination between 1, 2, 3. But we cannot throw a new one, 4. Those are the rules surrounding overriding. We cannot restrict the access of the method, and we cannot throw newer exceptions in the subclass.
It should be identical in both.
It cannot be identical. It need not be identical actually. In the superclass, I am throwing exception 1, exception 2, exception 3. In the subclass, I can just say exception 1. But in the subclass, if I am just saying exception 1, in the superclass, if I am saying just exception 1, in the subclass, I cannot say exception 1 and exception 2.
Okay. The priority work comes from superclass.
Yes, exactly. You cannot define or throw new exceptions in the subclass.
Right.
And one more thing is, we cannot restrict the access in the subclass.
Yes.
Okay. So, when you have an instance method in the subclass, with the same signature as that of the superclass, the superclass method is hidden in that instance. And that is the reason when we execute the code, you know, the superclass method is hidden and the subclass method gets called, right?
Yes.
So a method is said to be overridden if the class extends another class and defines a method with the same name and argument list. So the method defined in the superclass will be visible in the derived class, right? Okay, let me tell you this. What am I trying to say is, if it is private over here, right? Okay, you won't be able to access it. And you are overriding this here. And we have the same signature here. This is not as overriding. We don't call it as overriding because this method is not visible in the car class, right? As it is private, folks, listen very carefully. As it is private in the super class, it won't be visible in the subclass, right? So we don't consider this as overriding. The super class method should be visible to the super class method should be visible to the subclass. Then only we call it as overriding. Okay?
Yes.
And we cannot restrict the access of the method, and we cannot throw newer exceptions. That is what is about overriding. So, you know, we have discussed overloading and we have discussed overriding. So, what is polymorphism in Java? What in general polymorphism means?
Neham, just before going to the topic, I just have a question here. Like in the last class, we have discussed every class is a subclass of object superclass, right? Object lang.java.object,
right? Yes, java.lang.object.
Yeah. And can I define, like in my, if you go to first class, in the vehicle class?
Okay. You want me to go to vehicle class? Yes.
Yeah. So here, can I write like object one equal to new vehicle, like that? Can I create?
Yes. Yes. You can, for that matter, you can put any object into object class reference. I can say vehicle, I can say car, I can say string, I can say anything, because object is the super class of all the classes.
Okay. I don't know. I was getting an error. That's the reason I don't know. I was getting the method is undefined for the type of object.
Yes, I know what that is. See, I can do this, but I cannot say object one dot move.
Yeah,
it gives me error.
Yeah.
Yes, I know. When you say the error, I understand. You know, the method move is undefined for the type object. When we assign it to a super class or a super interface, we can call the methods that are defined only in the object class. But if there are some new methods that are defined in the vehicle class, we cannot call them on the super class reference. When we have a reference, you can call only the methods and variables that are present in that class or in that interface. Okay?
This method is within the same class only, right?
You have it in the vehicle class, but this method, we don't have it in the object class. Right? Do we have this method in the object class? We don't have it in the object class. On the object reference, on the object class reference, we can call the methods that are present in the object class.
Okay.
That are only present in the object class.
Okay.
We cannot call new methods. That applies to both class and an interface.
Okay. So then this has practically any use?
Ideally, in some scenarios, when we're seeing the practice artist, we don't create any new methods in the subclasses in that scenario. We just implement the methods that are present in the interface, or you know, we just try to override the methods that are there in the superclasses. In that scenarios, only we will be assigning a subclass object to a superclass instance. When we have the new functionality that is written more in the subclass, we don't do that. We don't assign a subclass object to a superclass instance, right? Because we won't be able to use the functionality at all. Not at all. We won't be able to use at least some part of the functionality, right?
Okay. That's what, like, I was just trying to access this method in the...
Yes, I got it when you said the error. I mean, you said the error. You described the error, right? So,
yeah,
then I understood you might be doing this.
Yeah.
Yes, that's good.
Okay.
So, Neha, in overriding, can we do, like, can there be a situation where you have part of the code in vehicle and I want to continue that in car also? So will there be a situation that you do both, you can call both of the methods?
Yes. See.
And
yeah, the next is what I'm going to do that.
Sure.
So for example, what happens is in a subclass method, you want the superclass behavior. Okay. In addition to that, you want something else. So we say use the keyword super. Super keyword is used to call the superclass constructors and superclass methods also. So if you call this calls the method in the superclass. When I say this calls, okay, let me take off call this, like, you know, could be confusing. See, when I run this, it first calls the superclass method and then it executes the code, whatever is present. So I'm using the keyword super to call the method in the superclass. Sometimes the scenario happens that whatever the superclass method is doing, you want to do that. In addition to that, you want to do, you know, something else also. So there is no point in you writing the code again, right? The same code again here. So we call the superclass method using the keyword super. Super dot method name. Folks, is it better now? Venkat, are you able to hear me?
Yeah, now it is fine, but when you are explaining, it was completely breaking. So I think meaning to repeat. Sorry about that.
Hey, no problem. I'll do that. If something is breaking, please don't hesitate to ask me to repeat. That's my pleasure. See.
Again breaking.
Really? Okay, I'll start talking. Let me know, if it's still breaking. Is it better now, everyone?
Yeah, it's fine for me, but I have a doubt here, Neha. Super keyword is basically used to access the same methods and variables and all the properties of the super class, right?
Yeah.
So the same thing we can do with the object too.
See, super means we don't create an object. It has the subclass has the ability to access the super class method. So when it is accessible here, why am I explicitly saying super? When I don't say super, what happens is the subclass method takes precedence and it calls the subclass method. If I want to call the super class method, when I override, I use the keyword super.
Okay, that's a much comfortable or easier way to do it.
Yes. Okay, see, actually, I was explaining there in, real-time scenarios, there will be some case wherein, let's say, I have behavior that is defined in my superclass. My subclass, yeah. I want to do the same thing. In addition to that behavior, we want to do something else also. In that case, we use the super keyword and call the method in the superclass, and after that, we write the code in the subclass method. That's what we exactly doing it here. We are calling the superclass method and then we are writing some code after it.
Yes, reducing the code duplication. That's what you mean?
Yes, exactly. It reduces the duplication of code. You can just copy and paste the code over here. It still works. But that's not the purpose, right? If it is doing the same thing, we have to reuse the code.
Yes.
Super is a keyword which is used to call superclass methods, or super is used to call superclass constructors also. Within a subclass constructor, if you say super and pass the necessary arguments, it makes a call to the superclass constructor, right?
Without an object.
Yes. I mean, we put it as a part of the constructor, right? That's what we were seeing in the previous class, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Any doubts on this before we move on?
So, Neha, if you have, like now there is vehicle, that is the super class of car. Now I have car 2 that I extend car. So, car will become the super class of car 2. And in that case, if I want to, now the car 2, the super class is car 1. So I say super, so it is going to invoke car as a super class for car 2. But what if I want to do a call from vehicle? In that case, I have to instantiate the object vehicle, right? And then use that object. Reference?
You have multiple levels of inheritance. That is what you are trying to ask. It's like car 1 is extending car.
Yes.
Hello, Lydia?
Yes. Car 1 extending car.
Okay, you can call. Okay, let me repeat it. You have like vehicle, and you have a car, and you have car 1.
Right.
That is the level, right?
Right. Yes.
Okay, and from the car 1 class, you want to call
from car 2 class. From car 2 class. So for car 2 class, super class is super is. Super invokes car. Sorry, car 1 invokes the, when I use super, then super class for car 1 is car. So it invokes that constructor or the method, whatever I call. But what if I want from car one, I want to invoke the constructor of vehicle.
Constructor of vehicle will implicitly be called. We don't need to explicitly call it. That is okay. What we were discussing as the chaining of constructors. Okay.
Yeah, but the right super down. So for car one, what is the super class?
See, for car one, the super class is car, and even vehicle also becomes the super class of the car.
Okay.
So for example, let's say this is the scenario that you are saying, right? You have like a say sports car and then car. This is what you are saying, right?
Yes.
Then have a constructor here, it calls the vehicle constructor also. Let me just quickly add the constructor. Okay. Okay, you have a constructor here, right? What happens here? This calls the constructor of super class. Did you please stop me if I'm doing something different than what you are expecting?
Okay, sure.
Okay, this is what you wanted to, right? Okay, we have a vehicle class and we have a car class which extends vehicle, and then we have a sports car, right? So, see, when I create a sports car object, it calls all the constructors, it calls till vehicle class. That is what we call as the chaining of the constructors, right? See, it goes to the vehicle class, then car class, then constructor of the sports class, sports car class.
Right. So, when you say super, when you are trying to
when we say super, what happens is it calls the constructor of the car class, right? In the car class, it implicitly has a call to super. It calls it super class constructor. So the vehicle constructor also gets executed.
Okay. In case of method, in case method, of like we cannot, calling the move.
No, we cannot say super dot move. Yeah. We cannot say that. Because it affects encapsulation, we cannot say that.
Yeah, in that case, you have to instantiate the vehicle car to sports car. Is that a true statement?
Vehicle car to
like
sports car
SP equal to vehicle, new vehicle?
No, we cannot do that. We can never assign a super class object to a subclass difference.
Oh, okay.
We cannot do that. You have to instantiate a vehicle class object and do that. We can go to the immediate super class. We don't go to higher level because that's the purpose of encapsulation.
Constructors,
because they are used, it's like the previous constructors has, the super class constructor get executed and then it comes to subclass. If you see the order, right? Here, the vehicle class, then car class, and then sport car class, right?
Yeah.
This is what we call it as the chaining of constructors.
So many of our students have given testimonials on how our training programs are. You will find them on kudzu.com and on our website h2kinfosys.com. On our website h2kinfosys.com, you will also find more detailed information on who we are, the courses that we offer, what each course covers. Also, if you're interested in a demo program, please register on our homepage on the left-hand side. Just give us more information about yourself and we will send you a link for a demo class. The demo class is absolutely free. Experience our commitment. by just attending an orientation workshop at no cost. Our team of faculty and advisors are here to guide you with the right information. If you still have more questions, please feel free to call us. Call us at 770-777-1269. This is a United States number. If you're calling from the UK, call us at 020-337-17615. You can also email us at training@h2kinfosys.com or h2kinfosys@gmail.com. Thank you for watching our videos. We wish you a great career in information technology.